But first couple laps, you're just trying to get a feel for everything, find your position. And then after that, you just see how far you can push it without breaking it for 4 hours.
Pennsylvania College of Technology students pushed their car farther and faster than just a handful of teams during the marquee event of Baja SAE in Pittsburg, Kansas. Penn College overcame scores of schools and muddy conditions to finish fifth out of 107 teams in the renowned competition's four-hour endurance race.
For a brand new car with a brand new drivetrain, which is a new gearbox, a new clutch, and a new driver, and nothing broke, I'm quite pleased with how things ended up.
We came in here knowing we had a fast car, but also an unproven car. I'm almost kind of speechless because it couldn't have really gone any better.
The students dedicated countless hours outside of class to design and manufacture the off-road vehicle. They made 85% of the car's parts.
In the fall, we were in every Sunday, and then in the spring, we had work days every Friday and every Sunday, and then the last month, we were Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
It's really just that effort, you know, it's all the late nights, all the times where we hate being in the shop, but we know we have to be there, and trying to make as informed decisions as we can.
They spent hours and hours of their free time and their creative knowledge to come up with a car that was competitive with the top 10 in the world, which is absolutely incredible.
Of the 100-plus teams representing top colleges and universities throughout the world, 13 didn't complete a single lap of the rugged track. 33 cars recorded fewer than 10 laps. Penn College's number 114 car completed 39 laps of the obstacle-filled course, made more challenging by the mud, resulting from 2 inches of rain that washed out most of the previous day's events.
It was more of a visual challenge because, you know, all the mud would splash up on your goggles and it'd get caked on your helmet. So it was just a matter of, you know, tearing off the little tear-offs that we have on the goggles, cleaning off my helmet as we went through the race.
At the race's halfway mark, Penn College's 335-pound car was running in the middle of the pack, about 30 spots behind eventual winner, the University of Michigan. As the course consumed other cars, the Penn College entry dominated the final 2 hours, recording a lap time of 4:55, just 10 seconds off the fastest one of the race.
Once things sort of thin out, then you just need to start turning laps and pushing the car.
And later we got into the race, the car just kept taking it and kept taking it and got faster and faster and faster. And we really knew that, you know, we had finally done something big here.
The students received more than bragging rights with their fifth place finish. The Baja SAE experience enhances their resumes.
There are employers that specifically ask for Baja students. All the problem solving, the critical thinking, the making decisions on, you know, off the cuff, that's the reason that these employers are looking for Baja specific students.
More Baja competitions are in the future for the Penn College team, but for now, the students are savoring their stellar showing in Kansas.
When it crossed the finish line, it was just, it's an unbelievable feeling.
It was just a big sigh of relief that the car held together and that I was done and I could get out and stand up. Being in a seat for 4 hours takes its toll on you, so. But, you know, I wouldn't do it for anything else. It was an awesome experience.
The biggest thing is I'm happy for these students that all this hard work that they did paid off.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.